You got a good knot, let go. Alright? Now, I am done. What are some things that I may not have done there that you may have gone, why did he do that?
Stitch them up.
Cats, we leave them open. I've never sutured any of this. And never had a problem. Okay, the crow folds in on itself and heals nicely. Tomorrow there won't be much of a sore there at all. So, there were some other things that what Sarah just did. She also microchipped him. The little microchip that she put in underneath his skin there, and that can identify him. He'll be registered to a number, and so if he's lost in his hand, he'll be able to be reunited with his owner. We had one this week that was microchipped, got away from somebody that they had given the dog to, and it came back to them. Alright. First, some questions. I told you it didn't take long. I'm sorry if it wasn't up close and personal. Yes, ma'am. I did. It's going to go in the garbage.
She wants to look at them. She wants to look at them.
Yes, sir.
When he was getting the accessories of the owner, why didn't she tap the
side? Tap.
I was testing how deep he was and to see how responsive he was. I've been checking his heart here. I'll reach down here and I'll check his femoral pulse. I'll reach up here and make sure that I feel some breathing because we don't have him on an anesthetic machine at this point. We're just relying on the medications that we're giving to keep him under. Sometimes you can give too much, you know, so I'm just checking his status, you know, while he's under anesthesia.
Yeah. What are some complications that can go wrong?
The most common, or the most serious, obviously, is death. Bleeding. Those would probably be the two most common issues you may have with this. Infection, which again, I've never really had much. Gave him an antibiotic injection before. And I generally do not send the guy home on any pain med or antibiotics. Most of the time that is it. Some other questions. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to give a sort of a reversal. The sedation I gave earlier had two drugs in it. This reverses one of those, and the other one will also just help with some pain. That one will help reverse one of the ones I gave earlier. It'll wake him up a little bit quicker. Pardon? It is not the drug. It's called anesthesia. It's a reversal for one of those drugs. We do have adrenaline here. What would I need adrenaline for?
If something were to go wrong.
I think I heard the word. Yeah. If his heart stopped and, you know.
His heart pumping back again.
Another question. Again, related to this, or?
Have you ever had complications with this surgery?
This particular one, remember that I have. I'm going to say I haven't. But I have had patients pass away, you know, young patients, because of anesthetic complications. It happens. We say this is a routine surgery, but surgery procedures a lot of times are routine, meaning we do them regularly and are comfortable doing them. But all anesthetic is risky. So anesthesia is not routine because we all respond to it differently.
Is it difficult to remember how to do the surgery?
about it, not when you do it a couple times. Actually, a technician taught me that when I was on my preceptor, which was my last 3 months of vet school before I graduated. I had never, ever done a cat neuter prior to that, because when we're at school, we a lot of times assist surgeries, like fractures and those types of things. Occasionally, when we're in what we call a trigger, we will do phase and neuters, but there's a lot of students and we don't have those every day, so it just sometimes what comes through that rotation when you're on it. I've never done one. The technician taught me to do that.
Yes, sir. What is the hardest surgery you ever done?
That I've ever done? Done a few fractures. I don't do those very often. Probably twisted stomach, called a GDB. Does anybody know what that abbreviation is? I don't know if you've studied that or not. Gastric dilatation and volvulus, GDB, where the stomach twists on itself. And it can cause a lot of issues. If you have to go in and carefully flip the stomach back, if it's not too far gone, the animal might go to the bottom. Sometimes you have to take the spleen out, sometimes you have to tack the stomach to the abdominal wall to where it doesn't flip again. Most of the time I've heard of them in large, giant root dogs like penguins and just things. But it can be quite certain and quickly.
Is it more complicated to
perform
surgeries
on
cats or dogs?
Depends on the procedure. As far as this particular surgery, dogs are a little more complicated. We generally will do it right in front of the scrotum, take them out through the same incision where you saw I went two different incisions, and we'll suture that.
Is there a particular animal that's harder to put under anesthesia than others?
Rabbits are not easy. Birds, I don't do anything like that. As far as cats and dogs, any smash-faced breed would be difficult, like a bulldog or things like that. Greyhounds and other what are called sight hounds, like Whippets and Italian Greyhounds, they're prone to getting overheated during surgery because they don't have a lot of fat, and that can be a complication that makes it difficult for anesthesia on those guys. Excuse me.
More.
I did muscular injections. Well, the pre-med I gave over there, the reversal, those were both muscular. Okay, I did give the white stuff. That was an IV. They did get a catch. I will tell you, a lot of times if I'm at the clinic, I'll just put a mask on them and gas them down with four gases. I just don't really use that white stuff most of the time. But you're going to have anesthesia. Gas anesthesia here. He'll be back on his feet and not going home with Kitty in the morning, maybe tonight. It's amazing how fast they recover. He may be a little sore, but you wouldn't be able to tell. If he was at your house, you wouldn't be able to tell.
Why do you do your animals?
Multiple reasons. Sometimes behavior reasons you'll do it. That's the reason why I recommend doing it when they're younger, for health reasons. Like females, you want to spay them when they're younger if you're not planning on breeding, because of the fact that they can get mammary cancers and they get what's called a pyometra, which is a uterine infection where the uterus fills up with pus, and that's life threatening. With males, they can have prostate problems, which you'll want to do neutering as well. Even if they're not neutered and they get older and they get prostate problems or testicular cancers, those types of things, neutering is part of the treatment. So, and then to prevent reproduction. That's one of the main reasons that most people think, but there's some health reasons as well. I send e-collars home very infrequently. I don't like them, it stresses the animals out. Most of my patients do fine with it. He won't have a problem. He may live back there a little bit, but I can honestly say I don't know if I've ever had a complication post-op with a cat. Not that I couldn't, but to the first one. What's another question? Again, related to this, back in the back.
What is the most difficult part of the procedure?
Making sure that you don't let that that vessel slip before you get a good knot in. Okay, because I don't know if you heard me, but the second one, when I went to grab the hemostat, it sort of, the teeth sort of unlocked a little bit, and it could have slipped back in, and that's not fun, because you got to go find it, okay? So you always, whenever I'm grabbing those hemostats, after I do my little tie and cut it, when I grab those hemostats, the first thing I do is make sure I've got a good hold on them, and make sure I'm squeezing them shut to where I can slide that off and form that knot, if you don't want that. I was in undergraduate for 3 years, and then I was in vet school for 4 years, so 7 total after high school. I did all my prerequisites in that 3 years of undergraduate, and applied when I got all my prerequisites done, and I got in that first year. Some people get a degree, the only degree post high school that I have is a veterinary medicine. So this season.
How often do you perform surgeries or just anything on rabbits?
I've done a handful of rabbits over the past 5 or 6 years.
Okay.
Most of them are neutered. Yeah.
Did you have a job while you was in that school or?
I did. I worked for one of the clinicians at the school doing research on hip replacements and knee surgeries and those. Bringing some money and
what is the hardest animal to be able to do?
That I do? Or
overall?
The only ones I've had experience with are rabbits, some horses, not very many of those, a couple cattle, some pigs. I would say the hardest probably would be the horse. Because the anesthesia and just the dust is what you're doing. Pretty hard. Going down and coming up that way. He hurts himself.
How often do people come into your office freaking out about something that's minor, not that serious?